What is going on, guys? Money Webby here, back again on Saturday. We got a nice 10-game slate, a lot of good games to choose from, some high-scoring affairs. I got to narrow down for you with my money six of my favorite plays on the board. We had a really good night with the plays last night. A lot of guys returning a good amount of value, so let's see if we can do it again. Be sure to drop a like in the video if you're ready to win some money on the slate. I'm excited for it, and definitely subscribe if you haven't already. So first up, I'm going to go back to LeBron James. He had a kind of a disappointing night in the first game. He wasn't as active from the field as I was looking for. He was only 9 for 16. I got 50 DraftKings points, but I expect in this game, it should be high scoring again. I expect LeBron just to be a little bit more active to try to secure that win. Like in the first game, he was just trying to get, I feel like the younger guys involved, but now like, when push comes to shove, he's got to be like, all right, I got to take over one of these games. I can't just lose every single game I go out, which is not going to happen. But still, he just needs to be a little bit more aggressive, I think, here in this one. So against Houston, a team that does struggle sometimes against small forwards, I think LeBron can drive a little bit more here, maybe get a few more assists, and he'll still be very active on the glass as they kind of play that smaller ball approach when JaVale McGee is off the court. So at 10,700, I think he has the upside to get over 60 drafting points in a game that's projected for a ton of points. So I'm going to go ahead and lock him in there as my first guy. And second up, Damian Lillard. He's priced down in the slate to 8,200, probably because San Antonio is normally a good defense. But in this matchup, their point guard play has taken a big hit, especially defensively, because they lost Deontay Murray, who's pretty solid defensively, and just don't have that same kind of mantra a little bit of the Spurs defense. So with Bryn Forbes there starting, he was picked on a lot by Jeff Teague in the opening night. Teague was able to drop 27 points on the field, so I think Lillard will be able to score a good amount of points, and his price is a really good value, 8,200. I think he can definitely get over 40 drafting points. Like, he wasn't great opening night against the Lakers, and he still got 45 DK points in that one. And they just need him a lot here against the Spurs, as DeMar DeRozan could limit CJ McCollum a little bit and make Lillard just be a little bit more open to shooting a lot of shots yet again here. And he can get some more assists. Like, he does have the capability of getting maybe like 5 to 7 assists here. So at 8,200, love the value. I'm going to go ahead and lock him in there. An underrated good matchup against Forbes, who isn't that great defensively. And then next up, I'm going to go with Zach LaVine here. He proved me right in the first night with just a lot of usage, as I expect going forward, especially with Chris Dunn out of this game yet again. So he got 19 shots put up, and he just dropped 45 drafting points, like a good amount of value. And the thing continues here where I think he'll be able to shoot the ball maybe close to 20 times again here against Philly. That game actually turned into a blowout, and LaVine still did really well. So against Detroit, I think this game should stay close throughout. Two teams that aren't great can push the pace a little bit. And I think LaVine can just get his own yet again here and get around 35 to 40 DraftKings points and a high usage role yet again for this Bulls team that really is lacking scoring with Chris Dunn and Lauri Markkanen off the court. So I'm going to go ahead and lock him in there. And for my fourth guy, Jared Allen, he's looked extremely good this year at the center position for Brooklyn. He's getting a good amount of run. Last year, he was kind of just underused a little bit with around 20 minutes per game. But now he's finally getting the starts and getting over 30 minutes. So he's gotten 34 and 30 minutes, which is a really good sign. And some good, solid, consistent games. Like, he's gotten a double-double in both. Same amount of shots, so it's kind of easier to predict what he's going to do going forward, maybe. Definitely a small sample, but still, against Indiana, a team that really struggled against centers last year, I think Allen could flirt the double-double yet again here. And at 5,900, that is a solid price, just because if he gets a double-double, like puts up like 15 and 10 here again, he's going to be returning value. So really good price. Brooklyn has been looking pretty good. Indiana got blown out last night, so I think this game could be a higher scoring game. Both these teams can run a faster pace, so I like Allen a lot here in a solid matchup. So I'm going to go ahead and lock him in there. He's looked really good. He's been very active just blocking the ball as well, with 4 blocks in both of those games. And for my fifth guy of the core, Van Vliet, at 4,500 with Wright, their backup point guard, other backup point guard, DeLon Wright. He's looking highly questionable. He didn't go through shoot around, so I would expect he doesn't play, and that will add things to Van Vliet's plate yet again. He's been very active when he's been on the court due to him being like their best bench guy by far. And he's provided a really nice spark for them in the last couple of games, 29 and 24 DraftKings points. And at 4,500, he just needs around 22 DraftKings points to return five times value. So I think he can get over that, get around 25 to 30 DraftKings points. Yet again in this game, they are in the back-to-back, so that could limit the starter minutes a little bit here. Going against Washington, they can turn to Van Vliet a little bit more here again, get closer to 30 minutes, and return some good value. Hopefully Wright is out of this game, because he's had an extremely high usage rate with him out the first two nights. So I'm going to go ahead and lock him in there as my fifth guy. And for my value, Derrick Jones, he's gotten the start the last two nights. He's been a little bit annoying, I guess, in the sense that he's just gotten in extreme foul trouble. But I think he could get some more minutes, honestly, if he just stays out of foul trouble, if that's possible with him. And against the Hornets, it is a good matchup against the power forward. That's probably the best place to attack them defensively against Marvin Williams. So Derrick Jones does have the ability to score in this matchup. You just got to worry about his foul trouble. But at 3,600, the good thing is that he won't kill you if he does get in foul trouble. He can still return value in around 25 minutes. So a team, Miami Heat, that's really decimated by injuries, especially the power forward position with James Johnson and Justice Winslow out. Derrick Jones, he's stepped up. He's done pretty solid when he's been on the court. It's just, like I said, the foul trouble that's really haunting him. But this is the matchup where he could possibly stay out of that foul trouble. As Charlotte doesn't really attack the power forwards that much, as Marvin Williams is probably like their second to last offensive weapon. So maybe that can work in his favor. But at 3,600, the value is way too good to turn up for a guy that could get some more run and has that ability to score. So I'm going to go ahead and lock him in there as my final guy of the money six. So you got Damian Lillard, Zach LaVine, LeBron James, Jared Allen, Fred VanVleet, and Derrick Jones Jr. A little bit of a mixed bag of guys. But I think LeBron and Lillard and LaVine can carry the load, and then some really good value with these final three guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Be sure to slap a like if you did, and subscribe if you haven't already to get these NBA videos the rest of the DFS season. Some good advice and just good information to consider every single night. So good luck in this one, and we'll see you back here again tomorrow.